Welcome back to Ozarks Fox AM. We're happy to have our friend Sean Paul live in the studio with us. Great to see you.
Great to be here. Okay, time to challenge your reality.
Okay.
You always do, Sean Paul.
Well, get a load of this. Here's my statement for this morning. Our government spent $20 million to fund a program that trained people to become psychic and then to use those powers to spy on Russia.
Snap.
During the
what the what?
Yes, and it's, you know what? It's almost like airtight. And you know what? They did it for 20 years, but they would only renew their funding based on measurable results.
How do you measure them?
Well, like 7 out of 9 times, they had a panel of judges, and it was airtight, and it was unbelievable. So, but you know, in our society, we look at psychics. Let's go to Still One.
Okay.
Who is this? Still One.
Oh,
Miss Cleo.
That's
Cleo.
Right. Yes, and yeah. People wanted, they dialed in, they called her for answers about friends, family, fortune, love, whatever, and that she took the country for $1 billion, right? But then she got busted by the FTC, had to give back roughly $500 million to people. Yeah, it was bad. And, you know, maybe that has something to do with our perception of psychics and why it's all fraudulent, right? And we just roll our eyes when people say, oh, I'm psychic, right?
Right.
Well, last time we talked about Edgar Cayce, you
yes,
believe in that?
Yes, and I do believe in
but
him.
That was from like 100 years ago. People might not have been as skeptical back then
right.
as they are now because of people like that.
Exactly.
But what if somebody says I'm psychic and that person happens to be a scientist and a physicist?
Oh, okay.
And
okay. Well, that's more credibility.
Exactly.
More credibility.
Still number two, this is Russell Targ, okay?
Okay?
Now, he would train people to become psychic. He wrote this book, and it's called The Reality of ESP. It is a fascinating, fascinating book. And,
but don't you do similar things like that in your show?
This is where things get interesting.
Okay.
The phone just starts making noise in the middle of our segment.
No. Bad things happen with you, Sean Paul.
Yes, right. So Russell Targ was a magician when he was 17 years old. He'd do a magic act,
mm-hmm.
and all of a sudden he'd just start saying things where he wasn't really sure where they'd come from, and boom, it'd be a solid hit, and people would be freaking out. And so when we were talking for an hour, I was like, yeah, I've heard of that. And to answer your question, in our show, let's go to the next still,
okay.
All right? Julie will be blindfolded, and she'll be talking to people in the audience, but she can't see them. And she'll go through what we usually do as an act, and they're amazed. But every once in a while, she'll say something, and I'll be like, where's she going with this? Mm-hmm. And then I'll look at the person she's talking to, and they're in tears. And I'll look at her after the show, and I'll go, what was that all about? She goes, I don't know, it just came to me, it felt like I had to say it, and boom!
I could talk about this for hours, honestly.
Right,
and
this sort of thing exists, and it's real, and it's like synchronicity, and people want to just dismiss it as being coincidence.
Right.
There really is something more to it. Let's go to the next still.
Okay.
And so Russell Targ, he was studying the mystics, and what are these? Buddhist monks,
yes.
And the Hindus, and for 2,000 years, they believe that we are all connected. In fact, the idea that we're separated consciously is more of a modern-day illusion or myth, in that there really is something to us all being connected.
I do believe that.
I do, too.
I
absolutely
that.
Do. So let's go to the next still, all right? Russell Targ, in addition to the work he did with lasers, he was talking to government, mm-hmm. high-ranking officials, and he came up with a machine that would train people to enhance their powers, their natural given abilities mm-hmm. with ESP. He sold the technology to NASA.
Oh.
So that astronauts could be more intuitive when they're up there doing dangerous
Does
things.
Does ESP stand for anything?
Extrasensory perception.
I'm glad you guys knew that. I didn't
yes,
know.
You have like a third eye, and it just needs to be awakened. And he said we easily have more than 5 senses.
Well, and I think more people are obviously prone to this ability.
Yeah, but you have to be trained on how to open yourself up to it. And,
right.
and so he got grant money from the CIA, the NSA, and all these different government agencies to create SRI. Next still would be good. Yes, and it stood for the Stanford Research Institute. All right, he would train people. They started by going on the campus of Stanford University. Somebody would run off into the campus, and another person would just go into trance, and they'd start writing a picture, and it would be of the location of where they were. Like 1,000,000 to 1 chances. 7 out of 9 times, correct.
Mm.
Then they started getting on a plane going somewhere in the country. He went on a plane and went to New Orleans and was standing in front of the Superdome, and a person drew a picture of his exact location, where he was. One thing after another, correct, correct, correct. So we don't have a lot of time here, but it got to the point where one of their psychics started rattling off the name of highly classified names in special access programs. And all of a sudden, all kinds of different levels and layers of law enforcement descended on their office. And they said they thought they were either going to jail or they were going to work for the government. Mm. And that's when they started the psychic spy program.
Psychic spy program.
Yes. In fact, one of these guys was so good at it, and I could go through one thing after another. Unfortunately, we don't have the time, but it's just mind-blowing how accurate that they were getting, that the CIA actually just kind of cut him out of it and took one of their top, they called their best performer Superman. Mm-hmm. He could see literally anything. He was tracking the subs in the ocean, Soviet subs. He had red pins on a map, and he could remotely see them. And so the CIA took him, and they brought him to Virginia with him to work directly with him. Mm-hmm. Shortly thereafter, he ended up dead.
Oh, man.
Are you serious?
From a heart attack in a hotel room in Las Vegas.
Really? Hmm.
And there was a ex-KGB agent that actually was speaking a decade later and said, oh, yeah, we took him out. Made it look like a heart attack.
Well, I thought they were working for the government.
Yeah, he was
working for the government.
He was working for the U.S., but the KGB tried to
take... Oh, the KGB!
The KGB in Russia tried to
take... The Russian, okay, so if he was... how would they even know about this guy if this was an undercover thing?
Right, exactly. Well, because Russell Targ was so enthusiastic that he had... You can't just be creating amazing results for the government and keep your mouth shut.
Right.
Uh-huh.
And so he was able to at least tell the newspapers and whatnot about the hide-and-seek programs and all the incredible things. They weren't doing anything classified. Okay. But then the CIA in Russia found a file folder like
this. All
right,
we're running out of time. We've got to
get
your video.
With names of the people, and they were going to get them to try and turn against their own government. And so that's how the CIA... Well, okay. So... Okay. I asked Russell Targ, was there ever in a case where you guys actually, in record time, were able to save the day? And so we have a clip from the movie that he created. Let's go to the next still. It's called Third Eye Spies. You can get it with Amazon Prime or iTunes. It's available that way. And in the words of Jimmy Carter, this is what they were able to do. Let's run the video.
We had a small plane go down somewhere in Africa, and we were not able to find it by surveillance. So the director of the CIA heard about a woman in California that was a medium or something. I don't know the title for it. And she gave him the latitude and longitude of the plane's whereabouts. We located the plane where she said it was. And that's the only time that I ever experienced something that was inexplicable while I was present.
There you go.
So much we don't know.
And next week I'll keep talking about it, and Julie will be here, and she'll give you a demonstration of remote
viewing. Wow.
Love it. Thank you, Sean. We always
thanks, Sean Paul. We'll be back to wrap things up right after this. I'm sensing... I'm out of it. I lost it, Cal. I lost it.